I am Brother Matthew. Thank you for tuning in once again.
He will lift up Jesus ever.
Delivered by our General Superintendent, Pastor W.F. Kumoye.
Saints, God bless you. We're looking at Psalm 89. Psalm 89, I'm reading from verse 26, verse 27, and verse 28. He shall cry unto me, Thou art my Father, my God, and the rock of my salvation. And I will make him my firstborn, higher than the kings of the earth. My mercy will I keep for him forevermore, and my covenant shall stand fast with him. You're going to find in those verses we're going together now, the word covenant. This is a covenant month. And in all this covenant month, the Lord has been revealing to us the blessings of the covenant, the benefits of the covenant. I want to make you and I, every one of us, the beneficiaries of the covenant. And we're looking at one of those benefits here today in verse 27. In verse 27 it says, I will make him my firstborn higher than the kings of the earth. The word higher, I'm talking to you this morning, on higher grounds through covenant promises. Higher grounds, God will lift you up. I said the Lord will lift you up. You'll be higher this year than you ever were every area of your life in Jesus' name. Higher grounds through covenant promises. We're looking at Hebrews chapter 7. Hebrews chapter 7. This talks about Jesus Christ. And then you see our union with him. Our identification with him. Our partnership with him, our fellowship with the Lord. First, let's see what happens to the Lord. In Hebrews chapter 7, verse 25 and verse 26, wherefore he is able also to save them to the uttermost that come unto God by him, seeing he ever liveth to make intercession for them. You want to remember every moment, every day of this year, the Lord is praying for you. And when you are weak, his prayer will make you strong. And when it appears that there is any need or lack in your life, his prayer will supply everything that you need in your life in Jesus' name. Because he ever liveth to make intercession for us. Now in verse 26, for such a high priest became us, who is holy, harmless, undefiled, separate from sinners, and made, tell me the word, higher than the heavens, made higher than the heavens. That's Christ, the head of the church. And the head and the body must be together. The body must be joined to the head so that we can live a living organism. And it says, our head, Christ. Our head, the Lord. Our head, our Savior. Our head, our Redeemer. And the one that died for us and said it is finished, we're told, is lifted up and made higher than the heavens. We're looking at Ephesians chapter 2. Ephesians chapter 2 verse 6. And I want you to join what we're going to read now with what we've read in that Hebrews chapter 7. Remember, it's lifted up. It's raised up. And it's made higher than the heavens. And in Ephesians chapter 2 verse 6, and he has raised us up together and made us sit together in heavenly places in Christ Jesus. That's our position. That means he's lifted higher than the heavens and we're sitting together with him. We're lifted higher too. This year, all the things that crawl in the valley will not get to you. All the things that crawl on the ground will not get to you. Because we're not in the valley this year, we're not on the ground this year, we're lifted higher than the heavens, together with the Lord Jesus Christ, and all the benefits of Calvary, all the benefits flowing from the throne of God, will be yours, will be mine, will be ours, will belong to everyone in the church in Jesus' name. higher grounds through covenant promises. We're going to look at three things in the message. Number one, better promises in the new covenant. Better promises in the new covenant. Anytime you use the word better, you're comparing what it is now with what had been in the past. Comparison between now and the past. We're comparing the church of this day with the people of Israel in those days. And it says we have better promises. We're comparing the Christian of today, the believer of today, with the believers of the old covenant period. And the world of today is having better promises. You are for this day, thank God, God's glory is coming upon your life. And it says you, as a Christian today, you have no right to compare yourself with those of old. Not even with Abraham, not even with David, and not with all those old covenant people. And you say, well, this happened to them, that happened to them. Some people are forever comparing themselves to Job. Or they say, you know what, I am the Job of today. But thank God, it says we have better promises than that of Job. You may go, amen. And because we have the better promises in the new covenant, that's why the Christian of today, the believer of today, the child of God today, will rise up to your privilege and to your inheritance. And you say, we have better promises in the new covenant. Number two, blameless purity and renewed consecration. Blameless purity and renewed consecration. You know, if you don't know who you are, you'll be living like, you know, the man in the valley over there, the man on the ground over there. If you don't know the position you have, the possibilities you have, and if you don't know the place the Lord has brought you to, you'll be looking down yourself and looking down people around you. But when the Lord is saying, arise and shine, the glory of God is coming upon you. And he's saying that today things are different. And we have greater privileges today, and because of that, our purity is that of blameless purity because of the renewed consecration. Blameless purity and renewed consecration. Number three, boundless power. Everybody say boundless power. You know, boundless power means, you know, an ocean that has no shore. It means a sea that has no depth. It means a mountain that has no height. It means it's broad, it's wide, it's deep, it's very high. The power of God through you this year, you'll be surprised. I said you'll be surprised. No matter what power comes against you, a greater power will rise up on your support. And no matter anything that anybody is trying to do, and as they increase their power, God will increase your power. Because this year there is boundless power for new creatures. Any new creature here this morning? What are they? You're only in the front seat. Everywhere you'll be a new creature. And then the boundless power that the Lord will give you. And anywhere you go, you're going to confront anything everywhere in Jesus' name. Point number one. What's number one again? That's what you have. That's what you have. Say, that's what I have. Hebrews chapter 8, I'm reading from verse 6. Hebrews chapter 8, verse 6. It tells us about the better promises that we have in the new covenant. It tells us in Hebrews chapter 8, verse 6. It says, but now, when? I said when? But now, as he obtained a more excellent ministry, by how much also he is the mediator of a better covenant, which was established upon better promises. Begin to think about it then. Anything the people of old enjoyed, you are going to enjoy more. Anything that the people of old possessed, you are going to possess more. Their spiritual life, you will rise higher. Their material life, you will rise higher. And the peace and the rest and the glory they had, you are going to rise higher. And you know, you need not God bless all those people. And people are still wondering, can God still do the same thing? Of course, yes. He'll do much more than he did for them in Jesus' name. In fact, you see, you bring all those graces together, everything that they had, and the Lord is saying, you have the better promises today, and you're going to be in the enjoyment of those better promises in Jesus' name. In 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 8, 1 Timothy chapter 4 verse 8, for bodily exercise profiteth little, but godliness is profitable unto all things, having the promise of the life that now is, and of that which is to come. You notice what it says there? The promise of life that now is. As you look at the old covenant, you'll find that many of the promises they claimed, they are for the life that now is. They conquered Goliath, life now. And they had water in the wilderness, that's the life that now is. And they had manna that they ate in the wilderness, that's the life that now is. And then they had all those miracles, physical things, material things, the life that now is. But now the Lord is saying, we have better promises, richer promises, greater promises, broader promises. It says, one, we have the promise of the life that now is. Whatever we need to make this life happy, joyful, prosperous, excited, the Lord will give us in Jesus' name. And then he goes beyond that, and then he says, of that which is to come, life now and life hereafter, the promises that we're going to have for the body, for the soul, for the spirit, for today and for the future, for earth and for eternity. Those are the better promises the Lord has given us, and we're going to be in the enjoyment of them in Jesus' name. In Luke chapter 1, I'm reading from verse 70. Luke chapter 1. We're looking at verse 70. Luke chapter 1, looking at verse 70. Yeah, it tells us in verse 70, as he spake by the mouth of his holy prophets, which have been since the world began, that we shall be saved from, that we shall be saved from our enemies, and from the hands of all that hate us. The hands of the people that hate us this year, their hands are paralyzed. They will not be able to lift up that hand to hurt you in Jesus' name. I remember that man of God, he came and then he prophesied and proclaimed the word of God. And the king did not like what he said. And the king raised up his hand and said, catch him and hold him. What happened to his hand? It dried up immediately. I teach you the people that are going to raise up their hands against you this year. I want to announce to them before they do it, if they are not careful, their hands will dry up. Because you know, the Lord is going to give you the better promise. And all the miracles we've seen in the Bible, we're going to see the fulfillment in our lives in Jesus' name. And that's why I want to tell all our preachers this year, all our overseers this year, all our pastors this year, all the Sunday scripture teachers this year, all the people who are teaching any seminar in anything this year, and read from Genesis to Revelation, and then read the word of God. When you come across a particular verse and say, I don't think I can read this, because if I read this, there are some people there that will not like what I'm reading. They may raise their hands against me. Hey, come on. Read that verse. Let them raise their hand. What will happen to that hand? It will dry up. Because the Lord will save us from the hands of all our enemies and of all the hands of the people that hate us. This year is a year of miracle. A year of signs and wonders. And you will not just hear it coming from afar. You will see it at your doorstep. It will happen. Go anywhere that the Lord wants you to go. Any office the Lord wants you to go. And then they say, you know, the promotion, I'm afraid if they promote me, the people, my enemies, they will not allow me to enjoy the promotion. Where are they? Their legs will dry up. Their hands will dry up. Because this is the promise he has given every one of us this year, that he will save us from the hands of all the enemies that hate us. And then in verse 72, to perform the mercy, promised to our fathers, and to remember his holy covenant, the oath which he swore unto our father Abraham, that he will grant unto us, once again, that we be delivered out of the hands of our enemies, might serve him how? Without fear. This year, there is no fear in your life. There's no fight in your life. You know, there are some people, they run away from the heritage the Lord has given them because they're afraid. Stay where you are. The blessing will reach you there. And whatever storm arises, the Lord will quench everything and stop everything in Jesus' name. This year we're going to serve the Lord without fear. In the day and in the night. During the week and on Sunday when we come to worship the Lord, we serve the Lord without fear. And it says in verse 75, in holiness. Holiness. I'm not going to release you from that verse until I spell it out for you. Holiness, humility. You assure you, man of God, what is required of you? That you walk humbly with your God. In holiness, that's obedience, as obedient children, not fashioning yourself according to your former laws. In holiness, that's the love. By day shall all men know that ye are my disciples, if ye have love one for another. And then it says in holiness, that he is in innocence, integrity, that till the world shall last, I'll keep my integrity and no man shall reproach me. Holiness is aim. And then it says in newness of life, that we should no more live our lives in sin, but live in newness of life. Holiness if there is endurance. He that endureth to the end, the same shall be saved. And then it tells us, holiness is an S there, which is separation. Come out from among them and be separate, says the Lord. Then I will receive you, and you shall be my sons and my daughters, says the Lord Almighty. The final S there, self-denial. That he looked at the people that followed him and he said, except you take your cross and deny yourself, you cannot be my disciple. This year will be a year of holiness in Jesus' name. In holiness and righteousness before him, how long? All the days of our life. That's the better promise the Lord has given us. We're going to endure it. We're going to demonstrate it. We're going to live in it. And nobody is going to beat us out of it in Jesus' name. In 2 Peter chapter 1. 2 Peter chapter 1. The better promises in the new covenant. 2 Peter chapter 1. I'm reading from verse 8. According as his divine power has given unto us all things that pertain unto life and godliness through the knowledge of him that has called us to what? To this grace? To what? To glory. And to vice? Villainy. What? Virtue. It was supposed to be virtuous. The wife at home must be virtuous. Our daughters must be virtuous. Our sons must be virtuous. There must be virtue in our lives. Our mentor, virtue flowing from our lives to other people every time. In verse 4, whereby are given unto us exceedingly great and precious promises, that by these exceeding great and precious promises ye might be partakers of what nature? Of the divine nature.